Welcome to Easy English by Eddie Singh, and today we are going to discuss subject-verb agreement. Shivangi, what do you mean by subject-verb agreement?
A verb that agrees with a subject in number or person.
Number and person.
That is called subject-verb agreement.
Very good. A verb always agrees with the subject in number and person, and this is called subject verb agreement. Now what does it mean? I'll just explain. You know, if in the third person, if the subject is singular, the verb will be singular. In third person, if the subject is singular, the verb will be singular. If the subject is plural, the verb will be plural. Like, we will have one example. A scientist discovers new facts. A scientist, it is singular, third person, therefore it is V5 singular, discovers. If there are many scientists, then we will write scientists discover. We will not write S. The V5 form will not be there. Similarly, we can have 2 and 2 makes 4. 2 and 2 makes 4. 2 and 2 gives the singular sense. They are not separate. They have jointly, they have conjugate meaning. 2 and 2 makes 4. Makes 4. Okay, Shivangi, some of the questions that I am going to ask you about subject verb agreement, will you answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, tell, there are blank several mistakes in your essay.
There are.
Very good. It is are because the word several mistakes are plural. The word is several mistakes, which is plural. So there are several mistakes in your essay. Much of my time has been wasted or have been wasted?
Has been wasted.
Very good. The principal as well as the teachers is sitting there or are sitting there?
Is.
Very good. Neither of these two books is interesting or are interesting?
Is interesting.
The books are not the subject. Neither of these two books, the actually here neither means not the, neither the first one nor the second one. None of the two. Either I or you are in the wrong or is in the wrong.
Are.
Very good. The songs of the movie are very touching or is very touching.
Are.
Very good. The father with his two children is waiting outside or are waiting outside.
Is.
Everyone in his family respects him or respect him.
Respects.
Very good. The great poet and scholar has been honored or have been honored.
Has been honored.
Very good. That means we are going to, discuss some of the rules. See now, in the case of as well as, we will always see that the verb should agree with the first subject, like the teacher as well as all the staff members, or the principal as well as all the staff members is sitting in the office. That means the principal along with all his staff members. So the subject is principal, not the staff members. Similarly, in the case of neither of the two books, like if I say neither of the two books, neither is always being considered here singular. In the case of neither nor, verb will agree with the second one. Verb will agree with the
second.
Like neither I nor you are to be blamed. So the verb will be with are. Now some more questions, Shivangi. Neither the captain nor his men are afraid of fighting or is afraid of fighting.
Is.
Are. Actually, neither nor, the verb should agree with the second one. Neither the captain nor his men. So according to men, it will be are. Okay. Both of these houses are spacious or is spacious.
Are.
Very good. Many of our problems are serious or is serious.
Is.
Are serious. Many is always countable plural. Am I right? One of the passengers was a qualified doctor or were a qualified doctor?
Was.
That in many of also, in many of, most of, actually we will always see that it's, you know, one of, it is singular, but many of it is plural. Many of it is plural. Okay, rice and curry, is his favorite dish? Or are his favorite?
Is.
Rice and curry is always eaten together. It is a single food. Okay. Tell me. Javed and not his friends is to blame or are to blame?
Is
to blame. We are talking about Javed. Javed and not his friend. Okay. Let us summarize. Now, in the case of subject-verb agreement, we have certain common rules. Ask sir, what are they?
So what are they?
If two singular subjects are associated with and, and if they give a single meaning, we will not use plural, we will use singular. Like you said, no, rice and curry is my favorite food. Bread and butter is my breakfast. Bread and butter eaten together, we will not separately mean bread and butter. Bread and butter is a single breakfast. Similarly, rice and curry is a single food. So rice and curry is my food. Similarly, when two, I mean, subjects are joined together by and if they mean the, I mean, plural, then we will write R. Like we can say, a very simple answer, we can say that you and your brother are here. Are here. He and she are brothers and sister. Brothers and
sister.
Raman and Madan are good friends. Are
good
so
friends.
Always you remember, if two singular subjects are joined by and, the verb will be plural. Verb will be
plural.
If they mean different. If they mean, like we can say, rice and wheat are corns. Rice and wheat are
corns.
Now, in case of one of, the noun will be plural, but the verb will be singular. Like one of my friends is coming today. Is
coming today.
One of his parents is here. Is
here. Here.
Either the mother is here or the father is there. So one of is always followed by a plural noun, but a singular verb. Many and more, or most of, always stand for plural. Many of my friends are coming today. Most of my friends are coming today. Are coming?
Coming today.
Similarly, as well as, whenever we are talking about as well as, along with, together with, the verb will always agree with the first subject. Like you can say, Shivangi as well as his brother is here. Is?
Here.
Shivangi is here. You know, I along with all my friends was there. Was?
There.
I ke anusar hoga. Because actually the main subject is I, not my friends. Similarly, with either or, neither nor, the verb will agree with the second subject. With the, like, neither Shivangi nor her friends are coming today. Are?
Coming today.
Yes. Either Shivangi or his friends are coming today. Are?
Coming today.
Either or, neither nor, the verb will agree with the second one. With the?
Second one.
There are certain nouns where they are uncountable, where the verb will be always singular, like water, petrol, diesel, you know, any liquid, anything which cannot be counted, like sugar. You know, there is sugar in this pot. We can't say there are sugar. We will always say there is sugar. The water in this pot is very hot. Is very hot. The information given by you is correct. Information is never taken as plural. If you want to make it plural, then you'll have to say there are several pieces of information. Several pieces of information. Similarly, advice. The advice given by your teacher is very healthy. Very healthy. And if you want to make advice plural, you'll have to say the advice, the pieces of advice given by your teacher are very interesting. Are very interesting. And similarly, distance is always taken as singular. 20 kilometers is a long distance. 30 kilometers is a long distance. Am I right?
Yes.
Amount is also taken as singular. Like 1,000 rupees is a small amount. Is it?
A small amount.
1 lakh rupees is a big amount. Is it?
Big amount.
100 kilometers is a long distance. Is it?
Long distance.
So distance, Shivangi, distance is always taken as singular. Always taken as?
Singular.
And always take the amount as singular. Amount as?
Singular.
Sometimes uncountable nouns always, I mean, they are always treated as singular. Like water, you know, like, you know, information, like furniture. They are never existing. News. The news is good. The news is bad. The news is?
Bad.
News is always taken as singular. Taken as?
Singular.
So let us summarize now by just giving a note that a singular subject, say like a singular subject agrees with a singular verb,
a plural subject
agrees with a plural verb, and now some antonyms. Quickly come to the antonyms. I'm asking you some antonyms. Ready?
Yes.
Oh, here goes antonyms. Lend. What is the antonym of lend?
Borrow.
Lenient.
Strict.
Minimum.
Maximum.
Modern.
Ancient.
Natural.
Artificial.
Often.
Seldom.
Oral.
Written.
Pardon.
Punish.
Permanent.
Temporary.
Pleasure.
Pain.
Positive.
Negative.
Praise. Praise, praise.
Praise, humble.
No, praise, blame.
Blame.
Proud.
Humble.
Public.
Public.
Private. Poverty. Riches.
Riches.
Quick.
Quick, slow.
Quiet. Noisy.
Noisy.
Real.
Artificial.
Our imaginary. Reward.
Reward. Punishment.
Rough.
Rough. Smooth.
Very good. Thanks a lot. Thank you very much for today's lesson.